Please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
What's up, Storm Nation? Welcome back.
I'm Alexa.
Maloha aloha.
I'm the Avogadro.
Applications for NJHS and NHS are now open. Candidates for NJHS must be open from 6th to 9th grade if a cumulative grade point of an average of 3.0. And candidates for NJHS must be a 10th to 12th grade with a cumulative grade point of an average of 3.3.
NJHS and NHS work together as the honor societies to provide service to our campus and community in a variety of ways while having fun. And yes, fun is a requirement. If interested, please sign up on the sheet outside room 319. Mrs. Lowell will run a quick grade check and send you an email within 24 hours.
All applications are due by January 26th. Please contact Ms. Lowell for any questions.
Hey guys, let's learn more about our Honor Society groups. We are here with the NHS President, Jacob Dodge. How are you today?
I'm good. How are you?
I am also good.
Good.
So, what can NHS and NJHS offer me?
I think they're both really good, you know, organizations. I might be a little biased, but they're really great leadership opportunities that we have. We really focus on serving, so we do a lot of projects and things throughout the year, and I think it could really look good on college applications as well.
I have to agree. That's awesome.
Yeah.
What projects do our National Honor Societies do throughout the year at Imagine Prep?
So we do a lot here and outside as well. I think a lot of us know about our blood drive, which is really good.
Yeah.
But also, I think my favorite has to be Ryan House. I really like that. And we actually go and we make cookies for the kids there. And it's just a really rewarding experience.
Cool. What do we stand for and what do we do?
We really stand for service, leadership. I think Ms. Lowell has the all of the pillars listed out. But just really being good humans and being leaders on this campus.
Yeah, that's awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Attention all winter sport athletes. Winter's team and individual pictures will be on Monday, January 22nd. Please see your coach for exact details for time and location. Flyers are posted around campus with the schedule.
Attention girls interested in playing in softball. There will be varsity softball open fields on IPS backfields Mondays on January 22nd and January 29th. Times will be 3:30 to 4:45 p.m. Please bring a glove, cleats, bat, water, and appropriate softball clothes. Grades from 7th to 12th are able to attend. If you have any questions, please see Culture Mold in room 321.
Attention all students interested in soccer. Open fields with Coach Wade are back. Join us on the backfield on select days from 3:30 to 5:30 p.m. Middle school and high school students are welcome. Make sure to bring water, cleats, and shin guards. Check for updates on the flyer outside room 203 and see Mr. Wade for any questions.
There are no Storm birthdays today. How sad. Now passing it off to Colin with Sports Recap.
Hey Storm Nation, I'm here with your Sports Recap. At the Heritage Maricopa tournament, AJ Stoltz led the way at 144, pinning his way through to win another tournament and move his record to 18-1. A number of Storm wrestlers also made it to the finals and captured second place, including Zach Buse at 138, Dorian Orsted at 190, Bryce Paulet at 215, and Jimena Black at girls 126. It was Zach and Dorian's first trip to the finals this year. Bryce's record is now 19-1. At the Valiant Prep Duels, John Ballman, Saleh Ahmed, Marshall Cantrell, Jonathan Cabral, Kyle Walter, and Bryce Paulet all had pins. There is good momentum leading into tomorrow's territorial meet at Superstition, Saturday's Mission Heights Melee, and next week's home meet. Great job, wrestlers. The varsity girls basketball team is now 6-3 after a win on Tuesday night against West Phoenix. The team's next game is January 24th at Basis Peoria. The varsity boys basketball team is now 10-1 after a loss to Sequoia Pathfinder and a win against West Phoenix. Their next game is Friday against Dream City in the Thunderdome. The JV basketball team is now 4-2. They have a home game tonight at 5 p.m. Join us on Friday in the Thunderdome for the boys basketball doubleheader. JV tips off at 4, and the varsity tips off right after. Let's go, Storm.
Now, what should we do for the outro?
That's a great question.
Anyway, that's the outro.
Yeah, that's it. Wow.